Please stand for the procession. Thank you.
morning, Livingstone College. Good morning, class of 2021. Good morning, Golden grads. Let me say that neither rain, nor snow, nor pandemic could keep us from this appointed round. Thank you for being here this morning. You may be seated. To Bishop George E. Battle, Jr., Senior Bishop of the African Methodist Episcopal Zion Church, presiding prelate over the Piedmont, North Carolina District, and Chair of the Board of Trustees of Livingstone College, to Missionary Supervisor Mrs. Iris Miller Battle, to the officers and members of the Board of Trustees of Livingstone College, to the Board of Bishops, presiding elders, general officers, and clergy, to the graduating class of 2021, their parents, friends, and others, brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, ladies and gentlemen, I greet you in the matchless and precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. And let me say good morning and welcome to our May commencement. It is good to see everyone literally in person. We welcome those of you watching us on live stream. We thank God that we are able to gather here today. Although we are still wearing masks and still social distancing, the miracle of today is that we are all here together. That in and of itself is worth celebrating and deserves a round of applause. Today, we celebrate a group of young men and women who have defied the odds. Matriculating through the college is tough on its own, but to do so through a pandemic is nothing short of extraordinary. Graduates, we celebrate your tenacity and your perseverance. You learn how to pivot and run faster to the race, to the finish line. You socially distance from obstacles and negativity. You prove that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Class of 21 and those here from the class of 2020, you withstood the test of time and did not break. Give yourselves a round of applause. Now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand and join in the singing of the national anthem, followed by the Negro National Anthem, Lift Every Voice and Sing. Both will be played on the screens.
See by the dawn's
be seated. Now, we recognize that God is for us. And we give thanks for his blessings because we did not come this far on our own. As an institution founded by the AME Zion Church, we give thanks to the Almighty God for his many blessings, guidance, and protection. So at this time, let us begin our program by invoking God's presence with the invocation by Bishop Seth O. Larte, presiding prelate of the Alabama-Florida Episcopal District of the AME Zion Church. After which, we will have a scripture reading by the Reverend Dr. Dwayne Walker, a Livingstone College Board of Trustees member and pastor of Little Rock AME Zion Church in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jenkins, and let me say good morning to all of us and to remind us that with God, all things are possible. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, we have gathered this morning beneath thy skies as we reflect upon the year 2020, how we were all hostaged, separated, afflicted, and affected by COVID-19. But here we are today, gathered here, yet social distancing and practicing all of the protocols, but we've come today to say to the world that if God be for us, who can be against us? We've come to declare that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. We've come at this hour, God, just to thank you for this institution. Thank you for President Jenkins and his staff and all of those who have made this day possible. We thank you for these students. We thank you for their parents. We thank you for the Golden Grads. We thank you for all who have assembled here today, both on these grounds as well as those who are with us technologically. We thank you, God, for our chairperson and the members of the Board of Trustees, faculty and staff. We thank you, God, this morning for our speaker who will come to inspire us. We dare not begin this event without invoking your presence. And so, God, we invite you now to come and to take charge, take over, take control, because this is your world. And we are those whom you said, let us make humankind in our image and in our likeness. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for saving us. Thank you for regenerating us. Bless us now and cause us to be a blessing. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. And amen.
Good morning. Let me call your attention today to the New Testament book of Romans. The 8th chapter, Romans chapter 8, verses 31 through 39. And reading from the New King James Version, this is what it says. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loves us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God shall stand forever.
At this time, it is with great pleasure that I present to you the Reverend Dr. Johnny P. Henderson, President of the Faculty Assembly, followed by Ms. Carly Patterson, 2020-2021 Student Government Association President, who will both bring greetings.
It's a great day. It's a great day. It's a great day. To the very eminent 12th president